Hi Pete, I'm Matt from Rival Bike in Barcelona. I'm the CEO and founder of the company. I started 3 years ago with Revolt, with my passion for design and technology. So I wanted a way to really merge those two things, the lifestyle part of cycling with the high tech of the high tech industry. So we created Revolt, which is a brand, yesterday's charm, tomorrow's technology, today's solution. So we do like timeless pieces of transportation, which are the design harkens back to the first era of motorcycling, to really bring back to our customer to the essence of the thing, but with a really big twist in technology, where we have super efficient motors and a connected technology, where we can really fully parameter all our bike. It's quite amazing, like how details can we go. We can change anything from the max speed, power of the motor, the regen braking system, even online support. You can, basically you can configure to make it legal in any country in the world or any states. I know New York City, California have totally different regulation. So we can make the bike street legal anywhere in the US, just with this application. We got a regenerative braking. It's hydraulic brake, but we also have an electrical signal that sends a signal to the computer. And it's going to make the bike go in regen mode. So regen mode means is like the hub motors will like actually works backwards, creating a friction like a giant dynamo, and that energy will recover your battery. So all the energy from the bike goes back to the battery. Then we can really set the settings to have a slow breakage with a low recharge, or really strong breakage with a high recharge. Then the bike has some AI features where you can actually detect the slopes, and according to the slope angle, it will give you the proportionate braking needs. Same for the power of the bike. When it detects a hill, it will give you more pedal assist power. So the Cruiser is really the first model in the range. This bike was really inspired by the first Indian or Harley Davidson in like early 1900, with a mix of cafe racer and of course the beach cruiser in cycling. So it's three different times, three different places, one bike. So all the details we make with all the craftsmanship, everything we do, molds like our logo copper. We love the mix of steel, copper, and leather that give that a steampunk look, and with a mix of technology that really enhance the steampunk feel. Then we love the lifestyle part of cycling, so it's very important to have all those accessories. We have vintage helmets, we will have like clothing garment to really be a lifestyle brand of transportation. Price point of the Cruiser is just below 3,000 with a 500 watt motor and a 10.5 amp battery. Then we can go to a 1,000 watt motor and a 21 amp battery, and that is a 4,000. Cruiser being it's a specific geometry. I mean, me, I love riding it because it's just like a motorcycle feel. You don't have to lean on your arm. It's actually really comfortable. But some of the pure cyclists are a bit turned off by the position. So we created the Torino, which is really the hybrid between a normal bike and the Cruiser. It's got the geometry, the perfect triangle between the saddle, the pedals, and the stem. So you got the normal geometry of a mountain bike or fixed gear bike, but with the cafe racer look and feel of the Cruiser. So again, we use the same materials, all the copper, leather, steel, all those same look and feel, but into like a normal, more ergonomic geometry. This bike is actually really fun to cycle. It's so like short in its wheelbase, and it's like a high performance bicycle. We have 80 millimeter rims with smaller tires, just a 2.1 tires that gives a perfect round section, similar to a MotoGP. So it's really good for carving. I mean, that would be the perfect getaway bike if you want to rob a bank, really. It's exactly the same as a Torino. So 3,000 with the 500 watt motor and 10.5 battery, and 4,000 with the 1,000 watt motors and the 21 amp battery. It's LED lightning. All the wiring is hidden into the bike. I mean, the Cruiser, we make it in a smaller version, which is really good for like a petite lady or anybody like less than 5'5". In Europe, it's very popular with teenagers because you can legally ride an e-bike at 12-year-old. So it's a perfect thing to go to school when it's a bit far away. You can go on bike lane and you can actually, with the Ava computer, the parents can actually tune the max power and the max speed to like, let's say 10 miles an hour or anything you want. Pricing is exactly the same as it's a cruiser, but a smaller size. Okay. So it's exactly the same as a cruiser. Then we have the Ambassador, which is really for the lover of bicycle. We went back to the really the first really good quality frame with Columbus chromoly steel, the brazen lugs. The battery is totally hidden into the bag. Underneath, it's a docking base. With the connection is just made with like those water kettle connectors, so you can just take off from the base and charge the battery at work. This is still a prototype. We will have some D-ring, so you can actually wear your battery on the way. So half of the battery, the bag is the battery. The rest is to put your charger or anything you want. It's like your briefcase. There's a really big work in anodizing all the materials. It's like copper anodized. Again, that's a prototype. The hub will be anodized the exact same color. So the copper, silver, and copper really reminds like those luxury watch. So it's the same. It's a yesterday's charm, but with the twist of technology. We have the same computer interface with the bike. So all those technology, leather and copper, makes that incredible feel. You will see in the saddle some incredible craftsmanship as well. Everything is dipped into it's chromoly steel, also dipped into the copper. The power is a 500 watt motor, the same we put on the cruiser, the smaller version. We can tune it down from 250 to 500 watt. I find it a little bit powerful for this bike because it's very efficient as a to pedal. So like tune it down to 250 watt is my best. I don't like to use small motors. I feel it's like a car that is designed to go 100 miles an hour will be very uncomfortable at 100 miles an hour, while you get a sport car and it will be very comfortable at 100 miles. So we use always oversized motor, now we tune it down in the controller. So this is the range we offer so far, but by next year we will have our full range. So of course the Cruiser, which is our flap chic model, that is the beginning of the brand. Torino, which is the hybrid between a conventional bike and the Cruiser. We will come up with a price point bike. The Beachin will come out like just before Christmas. It will be like a beach cruiser with like big fat tires. On this one, because there is we want to get into the below $2,000 price point, which is really the psychological bar for many. So we will use a normal 250 watt motor that we buy from the shelf like most of our competitors. We will not use our design, which costs too much. And same for the battery, we will use a 36 volt battery instead of 48 volt to be able to push the bar in like normal PU saddle. But we will have a price point at $19,999. Clubman will be really I believe that will be the best seller for commuting because it's stylish but conventional. You don't draw that much attention. It will be an aluminium thermoform tube. Battery again in the bottom tube. I do not like to put batteries in a tank like most of the cruisers do. It just raises the center of gravity, which is not good for handling. So this bike, the strategy will be to come up with a price point with a 250 watt motor, so to have like a below 2000 bar, and then use as well our technology so it can go up to 4000 with the 1000 watt motor and the 21 ampere battery. That configuration, I mean, our motor with our big battery, top speed is 32 miles per hour. Again, you can tune it down in the software to make it street legal anywhere in the States. And the range at full power is 50 miles at full power. And then the Ambassador, which is really the classic vintage bicycle. A beautiful project. That's actually the first project I worked on when I started Revolt. It's because I just fell in love with a cargo bike. I have three young kids, and so I use the prototype of the Trixie in Barcelona as my car. I don't have a car anymore. So this bike will come out in next spring. It's the main difference with most of the cargo bike is the cargo area does not move. It is fixed in a bike. We just have some cardan, so only the wheels are swifting, so we can take a high speed turn. It's much easier to handle. Again, with that beautiful style to be like all leather and leather bags and all the craftsmanship that we like. The two seats inside, we actually wish to make them like some little Chesterfield sofa to make it really stylish with all the seat belts, maxi cozy adapter, like Isofix to put car seats. We can everything is thought through. The easiest thing is to go online into our website, which is www.rayvoltbike.com. You will find all information about the new models, the news, the trade show we are doing. It will indicate our point of sales in North America and direct contact to the importer in Vancouver, which are actually right now recruiting some sales rep nationwide, and we're opening the dealer network. So we are looking for reps and dealers in North America.
Yes, we are currently looking for reps nationwide. Some of the territories we're looking for are the Rockies, the Heartland, Texas area, the Northwest, and Northeast. So other than those spots, we have reps. And please contact John Rainey. I'm the sales manager at Trident Sports up in North Vancouver. And number is 604-307-1234.